Hello and welcome to our video. Basically, it's a guide for foreigners who wants to visit Görlitz and learn about more about our hometown.
But it isn't just a casual guide. All of us here work together to show you the beauty of Görlitz. It was much work to do, so we hope you'll enjoy the video.
Have you ever heard something about the mountain Landeskrone? If not, listen and watch. At the bottom of the Landeskrone, there is an alley of lanes, which were planted in 1840. Now you climb up 178 stairs.
That's a stony way up. So if it's hot, it is better you bring some water with you. Now we hit the top, where you could buy an ice cream or other things from the menu.
Only some stairs up and you'll be overwhelmed. What a beautiful view, isn't it? You could see the whole city, Görlitz. It looks so little from the spot and you just had to climb 420 meters to see it. That was really worth it.
Hello, I'm Paul and I speak about the Mill Obermühle in Görlitz. It was built in 1305. The mill is located at the river Lausitzer Neiße. Earlier, the Mill Obermühle was one of three big grain mills of the town of Görlitz. Today it's a restaurant and a bed and breakfast house. Bikes are welcome. It's at the bikeway Oder Neiße up to the Baltic Sea. It's a very interesting place for people who like it still and comfortable. The mill wheel was shut down in 1994. Come and see yourself one of these wonderful places in Görlitz.
Let me show you something about Görlitz, the Landskron Brauerei Schuldenpimist. It's the only brewery in Görlitz. It was founded in the year 1869. The variety of goods is really big. Some examples are the Puppenschulz black beer or the Landskron meat. The brewery has also a drink for kids. It's called Fassbrause. It's a lemonade. The main product is Landskron Pilz. Since 2003, the brewery has a summer festival. It's called Brauereifest or Brewery Feast. The company is also called Kulturbrauerei because they offer throughout the year many cultural events.
Hello, I'm Amelia. Here you see the playground with the only rideable miniature railway in Görlitz. The park is called Parkeisenbahn. The train drives around the park, which is located in the southeast of Görlitz. What is so amazing about the train? It's the fact that the vehicles look like the vehicles from the first German train. You can not only drive the train here, you can also eat and drink something at the snack bar or go to the playground.
What I like to do with my friends when the days and evenings are warm is listening to good music and having a picnic. The perfect place to do this is a small park in Görlitz, which is called Volksbad. In the middle of the park there's a beautiful lake, but sadly you can't swim in it because there are toxic seaweed in it, where animals can die and people can get sick. But it's still a nice chilling area. You can play volleyball and football fantastically with your friends. Near the lake there are fireplaces where you can have a barbecue. So if you want to visit with friends, it's a perfect place to relax.
This is a masterpiece of architecture, the Viaduct Neiße Tal. It's a railway bridge which connects Germany and Poland across the river Neiße. It has a length of 475 meters, a width of 8.50 meters and a height of 35 meters. The start of the construction was in July 1844 and the first train crossed the river on the 1st September 1847. Today the train connection Dresden-Görlitz-Breslau passes the bridge. Nowadays you can find a park near the bridge, a wonderful view on the viaduct.
Hello, I'm Michelle and today I want to tell something about the natural zoo in Görlitz. It's in the south of the town near the station. In the zoo you can see a lot of different animals like monkeys, red pandas, different birds, kangaroos and more. But in our zoo is very special because our place has a petting zoo with different of animals like sheep, pigs, cows and rabbits.
Then we have a nice playground for kids with lights and swings.
Here you can get snacks, drinks and meals in the park.
Have a good time and a lot of fun here.
Hello everybody and welcome to class. Here we are standing in just one of our 23 classrooms where we get taught in English and German. Our school is split up into two halls. First, the elementary school part, class 1 to 4, and the secondary school part, class 5 to 10. I'll tell you later why our school is split into two halves. Now let's move on to the hallway. Right now we're standing in the hallway at the ground floor. This floor has a really, really old feature. It's our school bell. The bell and the school building itself are the oldest component in here. So you got to see the inner self. Now let's move on outside. 115 years ago, after our school was built, it was organized as a boys and a girls school. For example, the elementary school is the former boys school and the secondary school the former girls school. So now it doesn't matter what gender you are or which country you are from. Our school will welcome you.
Do you like movies? Of course you do. Who doesn't though? Right now I'm near the local movie theatre of Görlitz, which is further known as the Film Palace. The cinema was first built as a restaurant with a big theatre room inside. This room is still the biggest room in the building, and you can see the old-fashioned style in it until today. The cinema has recently been renovated and two new rooms have been added, which are a lot more up-to-date than the old ones. The Film Palace regularly shows movies in 2D and 3D, but also things like operas, concerts or ballets, which have been pre-recorded in, for example, New York. In special events, the cinema shows certain movies and gives out free drinks and snacks. The cinema is located near the train station, so if you come to our town by train and the movie's on that you like to watch, it is a must to visit.
Hello, my name is Jamie, and if you love to go shopping, I can show you the main shopping street in Görlitz. Follow me! So we are here in the street Berliner Straße. It's a pedestrian presence, but there are also two tram lines. The tram 2 drives from Biesnitz to Königshofen and the tram 3 drives from Weinhübel to Königshofen. Here are more than 20 shops and lots of fast food restaurants and cafes. For example, the fashion store H&M, the shoe store Deichmann and the cafe Back Factory. At the beginning of the street there is the station of Görlitz and at the end of the street there is the place Postplatz with the fontaine Muschelmänner.
Here we are in the shopping passage Strasburg Passage. It was founded in 1887 by Otto Strasburg. First he sold line and clothing in a little shop. Over the years he bought or rented a completely house. In 1907 he built the conjunction with the street Jakobstraße and the place Wilhelmsplatz. The historic shopping center is an architectural monument which was built in Art Nouveau. In the restaurant La Galleria Italia or in the bakery Bäckerei Geisler, you will have a very tasty meal. You can also buy clothes for every age. And if you love to smell totally good, you can go to Perfumerie Thiemann. It doesn't matter in which shop you go, because you always will have a beautiful day.
Hi, my name is Enola and today I will show you the Park Wilhelmsplatz. It is the second largest city park in Görlitz with about 22,000 square meters. And it is located centrally. In the middle of the park is a big lawn, which is great for picnics, playing football, meeting friends or just hanging out. Lots of beautiful flowers are around. And have you seen the big end sign? It lights at night, that's really awesome. If you look to the left, you can see the Juliet Curie Grammar School, which was founded in 1873. It is one of the two grammar schools in Görlitz. And in the background you can see the very large monument for the victims of fascism. And right next to it is a small playground.
In the center of Görlitz, next to the Schatzfrauenkirche, where the shopping and the cultural district cross, you can find the old department store of Görlitz, which has been built as a Kaufhaus zum Strauß. Unfortunately, since 2009, the building is empty. Since that time, the building has been used as a scenery for the brilliant Wes Anderson movie Grand Budapest Hotel, and there was also a very successful fashion exhibition in there. Some years ago, the shopping center was sold to the Saxon entrepreneur Wilfried Stöcker. He wants to make a high-end shopping boutique out of the house, like he did it with the shopping center Modehaus am Postplatz. Right now, an architecture office from Hamburg redesigned the space. When the construction will be finished, the shopping center will be called Kaufhaus der Oberlausitz.
Today we visit the popular square Marienplatz. Here people from different places, towns and countries met. Also popular pieces of architects are the Augustum Grammar School, the Natural History Museum, the Tower Dicker Turm and Department Store. And just behind me are the fountains, especially for young people because they can jump on it or play games. On very hot days, dogs and children can go in them and refresh himself.
Hello, I'm Jasmin, and now I will show you one of the famous museums in Görlitz. The Natural History Museum Senckenberg. It is in the city center, in the near of the Tower Dicker Turm and the Marienplatz. In the museum are very interesting things, for example the aquarium, and there are many kinds of fish. You can do a tour through the museum. It's very interesting.
Here we are and relax at the Marienplatz. Behind me you can see the Görlitz Chapel and Kapelle. Come with me and let's go inside.
Now I stand in the 500 years old chapel. In former times, it was an orphanage for kids. Now it's used for events like choir concerts or art exhibitions. The complete chapel consists of three floors. Albrecht Stieglitzer, the builder, gave the Annenkapelle to Hans Frenzel, a rich merchant. He used it for him and as private church.
Hello guys, my name is Julian. And I will tell you something about the Museum Kaisertrutz. The building was a defensive fortification and its name gets back into the war times of 1641. The shape of the Kaisertrutz is a rondel. For the first time, the rondel had 32 bastions. Today, there are only 4. In our time, the Kaisertrutz is a museum. It is a very good place for tourists.
We are here at the Tower Reichenbacher Turm, near the Museum, Kulturhistorisches Museum or the Kaisertrutz. In 1376, it was the first mention of Görlitz history. It is 51 meters tall and is the highest tower from all three, namely the Nikolaiturm and the Dickerturm. In old times, a guard lives in the tower who looked out of one of fire. Now it's an observation tower and a museum. Today you can visit the museum shop and the tower from Monday till Friday. Come and see yourself.
This place is called Jerusalem of Görlitz, and it's a replica to the original Holy Grave in Jerusalem. Georg Emmerich, later one of Görlitz majors, donated money for erecting this place of devotion after his pilgrimage to the Holy Land. They started building it in the year 1480, and in 1504 it was opened by the bishop of the city Meissen. The crack, which you can see in the background, is not a construction effort. They wanted it to look like that, because it symbolizes the division between God and humans.
The Holy Grave is a craftwork which is situated between the church St. Peter and Paul and the main city. Every year on Good Friday, the Christian people of Auer and the Polish Twin Town are taking a walk through the city to symbolize the last work of Jesus Christ before he got crucified.
I'm Lily and ready right now for visiting the Nikolai Cemetery. They are the most important cemetery monuments of the land, and it was mentioned in the year 1305. The Nikolai Cemetery is a popular destination, and there are 17 walled houses with wealthy families in the 17th and 18th century. In the cemetery was buried the philosopher Jakob Böhme in 1624 and the expressionistic painter Johannes Maximilian Avenarius in 1954. This place was also used for people who died of plague in 1847. You see, at this cemetery is a lot of history. I hope you're interested in this place, which leads us to the back in the Middle Age and today still stands for the culture of our churches.
My name is Sammy and today we visit the Museum Spielzeugmuseum in Görlitz. It lays on the Rothenburger Straße near the cemetery Nikolaifriedhof. You can have a personal tour there with a person who looks after somebody. When you have kids, you can celebrate their party too, but you must call 3 to 4 weeks before. The telephone number of the museum, you can find it on the internet. I think young and older people can find it interesting because you can see how kids have played in the past. I hope you like the video. Come and see the museum.
The Tower Nikolaiturm was named by the Bishop Nicholas in 1348 and it's near the Zwinger. It is 45 meters high and down the wall it is 2 meters and 86 centimeters wide. In 1903, the last guard left his living room in the tower. Later, the tower was concerned as a lookout tower. It served as a town fortification and has survived a fire. Now you get in the tower and watch over Görlitz. A lot of tourists come and visit the Nikolaiturm.
Hello, my name is Florin and today I'll tell you something about the St. Peter and Paul Church. The construction was started 1425 and it was finished 1497. It is 72 meters long and 32 meters wide. It has a medium hall of 24 meters and the two towers are 84 meters high.
The city Görlitz has an absolutely magic place. It's the Park Nikolaizwinger and Ochsenbastei. You can see rest of the city wall in the park. In former times, the two walls with the towers, Dickerturm, Reichenbacherturm, Nikolaiturm and Kaisertrutz protected the city from thieves and robbery.
It was built in 1220. To 1949, the closer hang up the closest between the city walls. The entrance lays at the street Nikolaistraße and the exit at the Uferstraße. The church, St. Peter's and Paul's, borders next to the park and is a very great site. The architect Henry Kraft changed the place in 1953-54 in a very beautiful park.
A lot of people describe the Nikolaizwinger as an oasis today, so come here and relax. Every year at the city festival Altstadtfest, a group of followers to the time of the Middle Ages set up their tents at the Nikolaizwinger. They show the visitors the life of the Middle Ages.
The people also decorated the garden with wonderful tea warmer candles. It looks very well kept. You think you are in another world because the lights look so magical. The Nikolaizwinger is very recommendable. Try it out!
Hello, here we are in the Church of the Holy Trinity. It is a Protestant church and was earlier a cloister church of the Franciscan order. In former times it was used as a grammar school and since 1712 it is a church again. It was built in 1234. The church steeple was built in 1381 and is named Monk. Up to now, the tower clock is 7 minutes past. The church is one of the oldest buildings in our town. As Görlitz is a town that is more than 900 years old, there are many legends. One legend is about a monk wearing clogs who is said to have murdered a young woman. It took place in the Holy Trinity Church at the Square Obermarkt.
The old town bridge Altstadtbrücke is one of the two big bridges to Poland in Görlitz. It was destroyed on the 7th of May 1945 in the Second World War, but it was rebuilt in 2004. Now it is the best way to walk to the neighboring country. When you walk across the bridge, you have nice sights at the River Neisse. At the night, the border is very beautiful because on the Polish sides are many lights. When you get hungry, you can go to great restaurants near the bridge.
So what do you think about Görlitz? It's beautiful, isn't it?
What did you like most about the city?
And are you going to visit?
We hope this little guide can help you.
Goodbye!
Goodbye! Goodbye.